In this video, I'm showing you how to take photos with intention and how that will make you a better photographer. Hey there, welcome to the channel. If you're new here, my name's Chris. I recently quit my corporate job to pursue photography full time. I'm teaching you photography and how to start a creative business. I'm uploading 3 times a week, so please subscribe to stay notified. Today, I'm teaching you how shooting with intention is going to greatly improve your photos. Every photographer hits a plateau in their progression. Some people hit this 2 months in, others don't until they're 2 years in. When you hit a wall, you feel like giving up. You start questioning whether photography is really for you. This is a completely normal reaction, and trust me, I've been there a lot of times. In my last video, I mentioned how shooting with intention will make you a better photographer. I really want to dive into this. So what does photographing with intention mean? To me, photographing with intention means taking the time to compose every frame and thinking to yourself, why is this photo worth taking? A good trick to use is to pretend that you're shooting on film and that you're limited by the amount of frames you can take. This makes you stop and think for a second before you hit the shutter. In a world where you don't have to worry about filling up memory cards, it's easy to fall into the trap of taking a lot of photos just for the sake of taking photos. While looking through the viewfinder, ask yourself, is this a good composition? Is my subject interesting? What elements in this photo draw attention? If you can't find a single good answer, then why are you taking this photo? You need to be honest with yourself during this exercise. The same principle applies to when you're back home looking at the photos you've taken that day. Go through them and break down the ones you like. Is the light interesting in that photo? Was your subject doing something unique? Why did you take that photo in the first place? Again, you need to answer these questions honestly. What I'm telling you to do is hard. Sometimes you don't want to analyze your photos and you just want to go outside and shoot photos without really thinking about anything. And that's perfectly okay. But if you want to improve faster, start shooting with intention. Now you might be saying, Chris, I shoot a few hours every weekend. Won't I still improve? The answer is yes. If you do any practice, you're going to improve. I'm not disagreeing with this, but we need to build on this. There's a difference between good practice and bad practice. And with good practice, you're going to improve at a much faster rate. Good practice means that you're constantly evaluating what you're doing. You're also getting honest feedback from other photographers. You're learning what's working and what's not working so that you can keep doing what's working. This type of intentional practice is how you become great at something. We all have limited hours in the day, so why not try and maximize your time? Bad practice means that you're putting in the hours to do something, but you're not evaluating yourself. You might just be walking around the city and taking photos, and then when you get home, those photos will sit on your memory card for days before you look at them. You feel tired after walking around the city all day and you just want to chill. I understand that. This method that I'm trying to teach you is not easy, but it is worth it. If you're really serious about getting better, then go analyze those photos and take some notes. When you start seeing results, you're gonna fall in love with this process. Each time that you go out and take photos, you're gonna get a little better. And those small improvements are gonna compound over time. Then, looking back a year later, you're gonna be blown away by the difference. As you're doing this process, keep learning new techniques. I'm a self-taught photographer. All I know is from YouTube. That's part of the reason why I wanted to start this channel, to give back to the community that taught me everything I know. There are so many photography and editing techniques on here. Each week, try and find a new technique and add that to your photography arsenal. Practice with that new technique. Continuous learning is how we grow. The world is constantly changing around us, so it's up to us to keep up. You can't just stand still or walk. You have to hustle if you want to get ahead. I'm going to end this video with a real-world example of shooting with intention. If you've ever gone to a popular photography spot, you'll find the scene familiar. You walk up to the spot with your camera and you see 10 other photographers all pointing their camera in the same direction. They're all capturing the same photo because that's the photo to capture at that spot. That takes the magic of photography away from me. Sure, you can capture that same photo just to have it, but you should also walk around the area and find a composition that's unique to you. Get down low, find a new vantage point, and frame that scene in a way that's unique to you. Find something different that those photographers around you don't see. You might not find anything good, your photo might suck, but that doesn't matter. You've gone through the practice of trying to see that subject in a new way. That by itself helps you grow as a photographer. It helps you visualize scenes differently. Especially in the early stages, doing this will pay dividends down the road. Those other photographers that were trying to capture that scene will never be able to think for themselves and capture scenes in a unique way, but you will. If you've watched this far, thank you. I'm glad that you're trying to grow as a photographer, and if you can take a second to like and subscribe, that would mean a lot to me. I want to say a special thank you to all of my new subscribers. Thank you so much for the support. I'll see you all in the next video.